But here is our road to 270. This is the NBC News political unit. This is our competitive battleground map. All the gray states are where both campaigns are spending money actively trying to win. So this is the playing field. These gray states, from Nevada in the west in Arizona up to Maine's second congressional district, even the Nebraska second congressional district, those Midwestern states, this is where we believe the race begins, and this is where we have it right now. And right now, we would have Biden already with a win. We've got these states. He's got a 10-point lead nationally. And right now, we have some of these big battleground states, from Nevada to Arizona to Florida to North Carolina, Minnesota, Wisconsin, and Michigan, all already, quote, lean Biden, meaning we think Biden has a lead of 5 points or more. What's interesting here, Savannah, is that the states we haven't assigned, Iowa, Ohio, Georgia, and Texas, are, quote, toss-up states right now. He doesn't have to win any of them. And he'd still win the presidency with Barack Obama-like electoral vote numbers.
And you're talking about Joe Biden, but just for those who remember this movie from 2016, Chuck, when folks like you and all of us put up polls and put up maps that said that Hillary Clinton would win, and now you're showing a similar map, I think a lot of people are probably sitting home a little skeptical.
That's okay. I'll give you the Trump path. It exists. It's legit. It's the same thing. I mean, there's a way for him to do this. It's very narrow. But when you're trailing in the national popular vote by the numbers he's trailing, in order for the president to get to this path, he needs to get a job approval rating north of 46%. He's not been north of 45 in our poll for over a year. And he's going to have to get his popular vote number to that 47. And he can win that way, but it is a very difficult path as things stand right.
Maybe the dam broke. Trump is being epically outspent. He's grappling with major defections in his own party, facing new criticism just in the last hour over those Second Amendment people comments you just heard. And perhaps, most alarmingly, if you're just simply a candidate for president, the polling deficits continue. We've got breaking news out right now from a trio of new NBC News, Wall Street Journal, Marist Battleground polls. And it spells some serious trouble for the Trump campaign strategy in the Midwest and in the Rust Belt, the blue-collar battlegrounds. In Iowa, Clinton is now up by 4 points in a head-to-head matchup, 41-37 before the convention. Clinton was up 3. In Ohio, which just hosted the Republican convention, Clinton has jumped out to a 5-point lead, 43-38. It's significant because the race in Ohio was tied before the conventions. And folks, even though Iowa and Ohio are close, keep this in mind. These are the two states that Trump had been doing the best in this entire last 3 months. And then in Pennsylvania, it's a big lead for Clinton, 11 points, 48-37. Before the convention, we had her up 9 in the Keystone State. So not huge bumps for her, but significant durable leads nonetheless. But the biggest gains in all three states, by the way, are something that we're seeing as a pattern. It's among college-educated white voters. And here, the numbers don't look any rosier than they do on the national front. Our new NBC News SurveyMonkey poll out this morning has Clinton with a 10-point lead over Trump in a head-to-head matchup. And, of course, it's even more when you look at it among certain demographic groups.
Excuse me.